everyone, Julie Stone here, and today we're going to be doing a quick balance exercise. This is something that you can implement into your everyday exercises just to work on your balance a little bit. And all you need is your balance pad, and then also something stable to hold on to, a chair, a wall, a countertop, just so you don't fall. This is our public video for the month. We have a whole crew of personal trainers who have CMT who make videos every single week on our on-demand library at All Bodies Community. So if you're interested in hearing more about that, please go ahead, shoot me an email, julie@allbodiescommunity.com, and we can set up a time to chat and hear about your fitness goals. But let's go ahead, let's dive right into this workout. Okay, so you can do all of this on the flat surface. You don't need to use the balance pad. So this is a progression. If you feel comfortable with using the balance pad, please do. You can switch on and off and use the balance pad for some exercises and some not, whatever you're comfortable with. In addition, I quickly wanted to touch on wearing AFOs. This is also based on comfortability. I like to say if you can do your balance exercises without them on, if you're not worried about falling, please give that a try, because you're really going to work on the ankle stability a little bit more than if you have the AFOs on. For the context of this video, I'm going to wear my AFOs, but normally I would do them with AFOs off. So we're going to start again on the ground or on the balance pad. You're going to hop on up to it, feet about shoulder width apart. We're going to balance on this balance pad. You're going to try, if you're rolling out, to press in. If you're rolling in, to press out. Same to front to back. So try to keep those feet as flat as possible and very gentle bend of the knees. We're not locking the knees. So nice and gentle, core is tight, glutes are tight, and we're just gonna try and get used to this balance pad. You can shift your weight back and forth if that feels comfortable. Of course, please feel free to hold on to something. You do not have to let go. Okay, from here, if you want to stay on the balance pad, you can, but you can come down. And then we're going to go into a nice, gentle march. We're going to do this slow and controlled. We're going to feel how the feet land on the balance pad. We're going to try and go toe to heel, then heel to toe. We're going to see how the hips shift, kind of make note of that as we switch legs. And very last thing we're going to make note of, we're making sure we're not slowly tipping forward. So booty is nice and tight. Core is nice and tight. We're not arching the back. Perfect. Okay. From here, again, you can stay on the balance pad or step off, hold the wall, hold the chair, something. Legs shoulder width apart. We're gonna hinge at the hips and reach towards the ground. Squeeze the glutes, stand up. So we're not rolling the back up. The back is staying nice and straight. Shoulders are back. And we're simply hinging at the hips, reaching forward. You don't have to touch the ground. And then as you stand up, you're tightening the glutes. Awesome work. This one's a little harder on the balance pad for sure. So if you're not ready, you can step off the balance pad. Do not feel like you need to be on it. These are just ways you can progress the exercise as you get more comfortable. Okay, let's do one more. If you're on the balance pad and that felt easy, you can always bring it into a stagger. So one foot in front of the other, bending down, standing up. So that's even a further progression. So I'm just throwing that out there for anyone who wants it. For this next one, let's go ahead, let's ditch the balance pad for now. We're gonna stand and we're gonna go side to side. If you have something stable to hold on to, you can turn around, hold it, hold a chair in front of you, because what we're gonna do is we're gonna step, find our balance. Step, find balance. So if you need to hold, step, find the balance. Good. Awesome work. Really focusing again. Don't let that butt stick out, because as soon as the butt sticks out, you're gonna lose balance. So make sure glutes are tight, abs are tight, and you have good core and spinal stabilization here. Perfect. Awesome work. Okay, let's do one more each way. You are crushing it. Okay, last one. Okay, for anyone who found that easy and you have a balance pad, the progression for that would be going up and over the balance pad. So you're stepping up and over. And then up and over. So I struggled with a little bit. So this is just for anyone who needs that a little bit more, but it's totally up to you and where you are right now. So you can build up to this eventually. So next, again, you can do this on the floor of the balance pad. I think this is a great one if you're thinking about playing around with the balance pad, but you're not quite sure yet, or you don't feel totally comfortable, this is a good one to do. So we're gonna come back into that about hip width apart stance. And then we're gonna make some circles with the feet. So you're making circles with the feet. You're kind of pressing into the balance pad with the feet. The knees are bending ever so slightly. And just getting a feel for that balance when you do that. Again, if you need to hold on to something, please do. Don't feel like you need to let go. And if you're sticking your butt out, I see you, so don't do it. Squeeze the glutes, stand up tall. You do not need to look down at your feet for this one. We know they're there. Okay, go ahead, switch directions. Good work. Feeling how the feet are on this balance pad or the floor. Okay, last two. Awesome job. Okay, go ahead. Come on off the balance pad. Go ahead, we're gonna do some big hip circles just to kind of stretch out the hips and stabilizers here. Good. Again, you can hold on to something. Your legs are feeling tired, please do. Last one, and then switch directions. Perfect, okay. We're just gonna kind of shake out the legs just a little bit. This other leg's gonna get a little bit of work, so we're only gonna do a couple. And then I wanna make sure we stretch out the knees. There are a couple different ways to do this. So standing, since we're already standing, you're gonna grab your ankle, bring the heel to the butt. If you're like, you're funny. You can lay on your couch. So pretend this is my couch or the floor. We're laying sideways on it. We're grabbing the heel, bringing it to the butt. This side is laying against the couch. So that's a nice way to do it. That does not involve standing, stabilizing, anything like that. And I think it's a way better stretch. So go ahead, if you want to land your couch, we'll do the other side now. We're gonna grab the ankle, bring the heel to the mat. Okay, take a couple deep breaths here. And then go ahead, release, kind of shake out anything maybe that needs to be shaken out, shake out the knees. Awesome work, you crushed it. I hope you're able to fit this into your workout plan regularly. It's just a great little introduction to balance. We had some progressions in there, so you can kind of meet yourself wherever you're at for that day or wherever you are on your fitness journey. I hope you enjoy it. Again, since this is our public video of the month, if you're interested in joining our programs, we have some really awesome CMT training programs where people get together and they exercise in a small group format, people who have the same mobility and goals as them, and meet each week and work out. It's just like a really awesome space to be. You feel a lot less alone in your journey. And then we also have a big on-demand library where me and other trainers who have CMT are putting exercise videos on there every single week. So if you're interested in any of that, go ahead, email me or check out our website. And I'd love to hear from you. And I hope to talk to you soon. Have a wonderful day.